Hello, lovely people. I hope everybody is well and living your best life, or that you will be soon if you're not now. What have I got for you today? Well, this is something I've been wanting to record for weeks now. So you need to get your cup of tea or your drink or your whatever, get something to eat, get settled down comfortably, because we're in it for the long haul. I am doing a full face of new L'Oreal products. Some of these have been around for a little while. Some of these are like new to my boots. Some of them are quite new, but they're all new to me. I have tested out one or two things just very briefly, just to see what they're like, but most of them I have not. And I want to let you know if they're any good. Are they a good buy or are they bye-bye? That's what we need to find out. So if you want to see what all these products are, how they look on my face, and find out whether I recommend them, then you need to just give me a big old thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when I upload, and of course share this video, because everyone needs to know about these products, right? Okay, let's get into the video. So I have a whole box of things here. What have I got? I have got this Micro Tattoo Brow Artist pencil in the color, I think it's dark brown, ebony, in the color ebony. I've got this Infallible Mattifying Primer. Okay, so these are called primer shots. They have a green one, which is an anti-red one, a pore refining one, which I probably should have got that as well actually, but never mind. They've got an anti-fatigue one, which is kind of peach colored. The pore refining one is pink colored. They have a luminizing one, which comes in hollow packaging. And of course they have this mattifying one. It says it preps and primes skin for makeup, 24 hour hydration and moisture, extends makeup wear, ultralight formula, transform your skin in an instant with the new Infallible Primer Shots, our first collection of primers to correct and perfect the skin. The ultra lightweight formula glides onto skin for a perfectly smooth, hydrated finish that lets skin breathe. Apply primer alone underneath foundation or mix the primers together to lock in makeup. Oh, I didn't think of that. I could have used them all together, couldn't I? Mattifying primer absorbs excess oil for an instantly matte complexion. Makeup lasts as long as you want without unwanted shine. Now, I'm pretty sure in the boots where I was, they only had four, because otherwise I would have got the pore one because it mattifies and pore refines. But what can you do? So let's get a little bit on my hand. Oh, it's runny and it's kind of white milky colour. And I'm just going to pop it all over. Oh man, I'm so gutted now, because this would be a good one to use with, why don't I just move my mirror? Why am I moving my head instead of moving my mirror? Other primers, I guess. So you can mattify the rest of your face, but maybe porify in the centre. But the other one would work for both. Oh, I'm just going to pay extra attention to my zones. It just feels like a really nice lightweight moisturizer. Yeah, that is definitely not filling in any pores. So if I was you, maybe order online if your boots doesn't have it, depending on what your needs are obviously. They call foundation sticks, but they also call them shapewear. So the idea being that you can contour with them. So I have got 200 and 240, and I'm going to use 200 for my foundation, and I'm going to use 240 for my contour. They didn't really have a great range. They have a blusher, which comes in a few shades. I have got the shade Rosy Nude. They have two highlighters. I've got the gold one. I picked up this Infallible 24 hour concealer pomade in the color medium. So hopefully that will work. I did that rather than going with another foundation product. I thought, since they have an Infallible concealer, why not? And it was buy two, get one free, and also buy three products, get a free sponge. So I got this L'Oreal Infallible Foundation Blender. So that is what I'm going to be doing all the work with, because obviously that is what's meant to happen. Right, so it's got a flat side and quite a pointy point, and then it's round everywhere else. It's quite firm, but I'm just going to go and dampen it. I watched a Soph Does Nails video, and she tried out this Micro Tattoo Brow Artist pen, and she worked out that she should have put it on before her foundation. But I thought, I'll put it on before my foundation. So it comes like this. I don't know if you can see, it's got like little spiky bits. It's got like three little bits, and you're supposed to just do your brows. It's supposed to be like microblading, so that when you do the lines, it makes like hair lines. Do you know what? I'm going to start this side because this is always the brow that I like the best. So I need to copy this side, not the other side, which I always like the least. I need to get my eyebrows done, actually. I haven't had them done in a while, so apologise for the strays. She also showed in her video that you needed to shake it up a few times, so it was actually super helpful to watch that before doing this for you guys. And it almost, let me just show you on my hand, it looks like nothing comes out. Then you press really hard and something comes out there. It only seems to work if I press really hard on that side, so I guess that's what I'm going to do. It's coming out with a few strokes, but... So I'm glad that I only paid £3 for it, to be honest, because, well, you can see a difference between my brows, right? But I'm pressing really hard. And I thought I was going to get loads of nice strokes. I'm definitely going to have to go over this. It kind of makes a nice sort of guide to go over, but this isn't how I expected it to be. I do not recommend this product. And you can see, well, I don't know if you can see, but I can see that where I'm going over it so many times, it's actually making my skin red. I guess maybe it's only, it can dye the hairs that are already there, but if you haven't got the hairs that are there, then you think you're painting on your skin so that it looks like hairs. I don't know. I don't even know if I'll ever pick this up again, to be honest. This is just, ugh. So let's get on to the foundation. So they have 12 foundations and they have 3 dark shades and I have 2 of the dark shades, so I thought that I just couldn't pick them up because I didn't have them, but they obviously have a really crappy shade range. Like, this is 240, so obviously way too dark for me, but you know, like I said, contour. And this is 200, which is what they count as one of the darker ones, which I was hoping is my skin tone. Oh, hang on, this is 210. This is 200, isn't it? Okay, there is another one. This is Honey. There is a 210, which is Cappuccino in between, and then there's Toffee, and then we have Espressos. Introducing new infallible shaping stick foundation for long wear, customizable base that lasts up to 24 hours. Our first base shaping stick has an ultra creamy, no compromising formula, which seamlessly melts into skin for buildable coverage without the mask effect. The round shaped bullet makeup applicator allows for a precise, even coverage, while the matte formula creates a flawless, shine-free base. Create infinite looks with a ultra-versatile shaping stick used as a foundation, a concealer, or to highlight and contour. Choose your perfect shade and apply the makeup to your entire face. Blend for a smooth, even application. Build for desired coverage from medium to full. Highlight and brighten. So let's give it a try. What do we think? Oh, I'm so scared. I've never used a stick foundation before. I'm just gonna speed you up. So that is one layer. I actually think it looks pretty good as for a match to my skin colour. It definitely is more light and medium coverage. I feel like I've still got quite a lot of redness around here and stuff. I don't know if I love the finish, to be honest. It doesn't really feel like I'm wearing anything, which is great. And I don't know if it's just this sponge, because this is really firm still. Like, I don't know if you could, it's really hard to describe. It's not my favourite sponge at all. My number 7 one I prefer much more. I definitely wish I had something else on underneath, a different primer, because I don't know if you can see exactly where I've just put those stripes on. Can you see there on my cheek? You can see every single pore just completely highlighted. I'll try and blend this bit out, which is a shame because this colour I think is actually better for me than my other L'Oreal foundation. Didn't I just put stuff there? Doesn't it just look like it's completely disappeared already? I hate when that happens. Only happens when I use sponges. Oh, I really don't like this sponge. I'm so tempted to change it, but then this is what they've told me to use. I'm trying the flat side now. Right, let's go again. Right, that is the last layer. I don't even know if it's a lot really, but maybe it's not. us better. Infallible concealer pomade. It looks like that. It looks like that. So that's the foundation colour. That is the pomade colour. I figured that'd be okay. Let's put some under my eyes. I wonder if I should be using a brush for this. It's very soft and creamy, which is nice. It's not that brightening, I don't think, because maybe it's not as light as I needed it to be. But more importantly, does it cover up these dark eye bags? It looks better on camera, but to me, it still looks like dark old eye bags. Because it's so creamy rather than a liquid, it feels a little on the cakey side. But again, that is also down to how I apply things, because I'm rubbish. Just basically rubbish. I do feel like they work nicely together though. Like they've melted nicely into each other, really without any blending. Okay, I'm just going to put a bit more of this on my nose. I always feel like I forget my nose. But I think that's actually okay. Now with that layer, I feel like my dark circles are quite nicely covered. Going to use this next, which I have used in a few videos, so I guess this isn't a full new video charm, but I couldn't wait because my other powder was doing my head in. So this is the L'Oreal True Match Minerals Mattifying Powder. So this is like a translucent type powder. So far, I've really enjoyed it. You open up the lid, it's like that. There's nothing to tip it into though. It's really hard to see that, isn't it? And that's what it looks like. And then if you just take it out, it's really fine and soft. So the problem with this is that where do you put it when you want to use it? Fine if you can get some and you want it direct out of there, but say I want to put it on my sponge, put it under my eye like this, it's nigh on impossible. And then you get all your sponge in there and it gets everywhere on the bits you don't want it on, and then it goes on places you don't necessarily want it on. It's really annoying, which is a shame because I actually really like the actual powder. I just don't like the container. So I'm just gonna briefly dust down the rest of my face. Just literally tipped it upside down so I can just press the powder in to my skin. This sponge is so hard. Can you hear that tapping away on my face? Like, what kind of sponge does that? Okay, everything's lightly set. However, saying that, I do really like it. I particularly like it in front of my eyes. I can sometimes use it on a little brush rather than on the sponge. I was just trying to show you the annoyingness of it, basically. And I would recommend it is a bit more expensive, but then, you know, well, is it more expensive? It's more expensive than my free one, but my free one winds me up. So there you go. Right. Shall we have a look at this contour? Now, this is the bit I'm seriously scared about because it's so dark. Yeah, I make mistakes with it. So I'm going to try and be really, really careful. I'm like so nervous because it's so creamy. You need like the tiniest amount. See what I mean? And blend, and blend, and blend. This side always goes better than this side. I don't know why. Neater, fatter. Can make it work for sort of contoury, blushy. It's not quite as maybe in place as I would like, but it kind of works. And I take the tiniest dab to do up here because it's just so creamy and gets everywhere if you don't want it to. Trying to create a shadow. Right, next we have this, which is the blush stick. And it looks like this. So it's kind of like a sort of pinky, peachy, corally colour. Blends out really nicely. I'm going to try it on my cheek a tiny bit this side. Oh yeah, that works well. You know I'm a blush fan. I like a bit of blush. I like to be able to see my blush. I'm not a hint of a blush person. I am a full-on blush person. Oh, this is my favourite thing so far. Obviously, your foundation ends up going on the stick in the end. Just be aware of that. Okay, cool. I'm happy with that. That is probably my favourite thing. Yeah, they have two shades. They have Nude in Rose and Sexy Flush. And Sexy Flush was a bit lighter pink, so I went for this one. So this, which is the highlighter in 200, Illuminator highlighter. And it looks like that. And I thought there was actually only two, but I see there's actually four on the website. There's Frozen, which is like a white colour. Oh My Jewels, which is a pinky colour. Gold Is Cold, which is what I have. And Slay Rose, which also might have been quite nice actually. Because sometimes I find when I put the stick on top, it sort of melts the makeup underneath. Nope, I'm not going to use that brush. I'm pressing quite hard with the brush into the product now. Do you feel like we can't see anything here? Right, let's try it. Right, you can definitely see that, right? Not in a good way, obviously it needs blending. So I want to not really be able to see it from the front, but to be able to see it from the sides. I look so weird without any eyebrows on. The rest of my makeup done and no brows. What do we think? I feel like it is sitting on top of the blusher so I can see the blush through it and the highlight on top. So that's kind of good. But it's not exactly blinding, is it? Then again, am I a blinding person? Maybe I do want to just be hidden. I don't know. I'm going to finish the rest of my makeup off camera. I'm going to do my eyebrows, my eyes, and probably a bit of bronzer. And then I'm going to come back and we will see where we're at. This is my finished face. What do we think? How do we think the products were? What do we think about that highlight now? I can still see it. I'm in two minds. I'm going to have to watch this back and I would love to know what you guys think before I make a final judgment about it. What do we like? Well, I think the foundation might be a tiny bit light for me, but I think it's workable. It might be good actually if I mix this within a darker foundation that I've got, which I think is a tiny bit too dark. Although whether I can mix a stick and a liquid foundation, I don't know. But why not give it a try? I'm sure that's another video in the making. But otherwise, I don't mind how it went on. I think the primer is okay, but we'll have to see how it lasts the rest of the night. I don't feel particularly matte at the moment. I feel a little bit shiny around here. So let's just get a bit of powder on my face. I really would have liked to try that pore one, and I think I would go back and get the pore one. That's better. Because I don't feel that my pores are well filled in at all at the moment. So I definitely think there are better primers out there. And it'll be interesting to see how this foundation sticks on other primers. The blusher I really like. I don't enjoy the foundation product as a contour because it's hard work for me. But for other people that might be easier. The sponge is a pass. Don't buy things just to get that sponge because I don't like it. It's way too hard. And it's got a nice flat edge, which is true. But it's so hard. It's just unnecessary. Just so unnecessary and not worth spending extra money on. Hey guys, so I am checking in. It's about 8.5 hours since I put this base makeup on. I did get a bit warm and a little sweaty earlier. So let's examine and see what's happened to my face. Well, looking in the mirror, I feel shiny all around here. And this is already after I mopped myself earlier. So I think, considering it says it's supposed to keep you mattified, and to be honest, I don't actually think I'm that oily. Like, I'm a bit oily, but I'm not that oily. So if you're a very oily person or like a properly oily person, I don't think you're even that impressed with this primer. And now I found out there is a pore filling primer. I would much prefer that because let's both go in together. Look how much texture you can see on my cheek there. Just look all around here. You can see everything. Everything. You can see every single pore is open and shining, and that is not my face living its best life. That is for sure. A few hours ago, I noticed under my eye, look quite sort of cakey. Like when I'm looking in the camera now, it doesn't look that bad, but let's bring you in close. I smoothed out this side already, but maybe you can see on this side how it's sort of collected under my eye. And if I rub this around, but I feel like the darkness isn't very well hidden at the moment. I think I prefer the liquid concealer. When I look at my image in the camera, it doesn't look that bad, but when I look at it in camera, I think, ooh, old wrinkly eye bags. I don't think that highlighter like shows that well. And I also feel like the blush has worn off a bit. Has it or has it not? I'm gonna have to look at before and after pictures, but I feel more so maybe in real life than on camera, but I feel like the blush is barely there. My face just looks oily and I just feel really like you can see every blemish, everything that I want to hide. And it's come off my nose a little bit on the end. So what do you think? Is this my colour? Let's pull this down. This is the bit that, you know, won't even get that much sun. So you'd think that this would be less, more pale than my head. So the verdict on these products is I am not sure yet. Because maybe with a different primer, everything would be different. Like it would sit more nicely on my skin and that would make me feel better. And then even if it did get a bit shiny and oily, at least more things would be hidden, which would make me happier. What do I think about buying these products? I think yes. Yes to the powder, I like this. No to the sponge, it is so hard. It's just unnecessarily hard. I'm not sure about this highlighter, to be honest. And like here, it looks amazing. Like, you know, you've got shine. Put on my face. Maybe I just have to put a heck of a lot more on to get the desired shine. Okay, I can definitely see that now. Yeah, maybe with this you just have to use quite a lot more than I was expecting to, and that's the difference. Like I said, I don't enjoy using that product as a contour, but I will because I've got a whole stick of it. I'm not sure about this yet. I might have to try it on a different foundation because I'm not sure how I liked what it did to my under eyes. I feel like it's worn off even though it says 24 hour. It's so weird how if I hold my face up to the light like that, it doesn't look so bad. But there you go. If I turn my face down like that, can you see what I'm talking about? Can you see those like ugly bags? Because we don't all sit with direct face on light like we do when we're doing this stuff. That is for. And of course that pen I wouldn't bother with. There are so many better eyebrow products than that pen, honestly. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it was helpful in making some decisions about these products. And until you see me next time, live every moment well and take care of yourself and each other. Bye guys!